Hi there, this is Anmesh from PiXimperfect, and today I'm going to share with you how to create the evil red-green color grade with Photoshop. It's super simple to do. The first thing we need to do is to dim everything down, and for that, we will use a color lookup table. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose color lookup right in there. And the one that we are going for is night from day. So let's click on the drop-down menu and simply choose night from day. It's a very good LUT to make everything dim, dark. After this, we will be using a gradient map and the multiply blend mode, so that will normally darken everything. So to prevent over darkening, we need to brighten everything beforehand. So click on the adjustment layer icon again and then choose curves. And now let's take it up. Create a point in the middle and take it up. Just normalize it. It's fine. Let's close it. Now on top of that, we will create a gradient map. Click on the adjustment layer icon again and choose gradient map. Now inside of gradient map, keep in mind that we use gradient map to map the colors of highlights, midtones and shadows to whatever we like. So right now on the right hand side, there is black. So all the highlights are in black and all the shadows are in white. So simply single click on it once, and the one that we are going for this example, for this color grade, is this one from red to green. Now this is one of the default gradients. If you don't see it, you can click on the gear and choose restore default gradients or reset it if you want to. Just make sure you have saved whatever you have created before, have a backup. Now hit OK. All right, the next thing we need to do is to change this to multiply. Click on the blend mode drop down menu and simply choose multiply. You see that we are coming close to the color. Now that we look at it, it looks very dark, which means that we need to go back to the curves right in there, which was for brightening stuff. Double click on the symbol to bring up the properties back again and take it higher even more. Just make sure that you're not losing the details. All right, this seems to be fine. Now to add some dramatic highlights, we will use blend if. So create a curves adjustment layer again at the top. I just love curves. So let's create one at the top. And now let's take it up as well. Click and create a point in the middle. Take it all the way up. Double click on the right hand side of the curves layer. With the help of blend if, I want to take away the brightness from the dark areas of the underlying layer, or the layers which are lying under it, right? So we will take the slider from the left to right, taking away the dark areas of the underlying layer from the current layer. Let's take it even further. Look, the transition is very harsh. So hold the Alt key or the Option key and click on the slider to break it apart and take it apart to make the transition smoother. See, I like that. Make it as smooth as you want. We're gonna keep it this way. This looks nice. Hit OK once you're satisfied with this. Now, we want to add more highlight to this. To add more highlight, simply create one more curves adjustment layer. Too many curves. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves again and take this point at the top, or you can also take this slider to the left, just like this. Just make sure that you're not losing details, because beyond this point, see, we are losing details right in there. A little bit clipping here and there is fine, but a lot doesn't look good. Hold the Alt key or the Option key. This will help you see where you are losing the details. Look where the artifacts are showing up. So stop just right there. A little bit clipping here and there is fine. Now, to add even more drama, let's create a curve to it. So click and create a point right there and just add some curves. Look at the drama. Now, there is one problem to it. Look at the band. It's kind of too dark and losing a lot of details. We want the details in the band back. So first of all, let's make a group of all of this. So with the topmost adjustment selected, hold the Shift key. Select the bottommost adjustment, press Ctrl or Command G. Of course, let's go ahead and decrease the opacity. It's kind of too much, so we're going to keep it to about 84. That seems about right. See, now we are seeing a little bit of the band, but we want to see more of it. So click on the mask button. Now simply take the brush, take a soft round brush and paint with black on the band. Make sure the mask is selected right there. And just bring back all the details. I know this is extreme, but don't you worry about that. We will just fade it. If you have painted a little extra, don't worry. Press X to toggle the foreground and the background colors. And paint with white on the excessive areas. First of all, make sure everything is filled in. If you hold the Alt key or the Option key, click on the mask, you'll see some of the areas are left out. So paint those areas in black. All right, hold the Alt key or the Option key, click on the mask to bring everything back in. Now, with the mask selected, open up the Properties. Go to Window and then click on Properties. Now, inside of the Properties, just simply decrease the density. The mask disappears slowly and gradually. It's like the opacity for the mask. I think I'm going to keep it to about 25. That way, we have some details. And there you have it, my friend, the evil red-green color grade. I hope you have fun trying this with your images. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you guys again on my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.